first and most important commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is salah. If we preserve our salah, all your life will come in order itself. You know, Allah will take care of the rest. Salah. Salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the distinction between a believer and a kafir, a Muslim and a kafir, is salah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith is Sahih Muslim, man aqama salata faqad aqama ad-deena kullah. A person who establishes his salah, he's established his whole deen. And a person who wastes his salah, he says, فَقَدْ أَضَاعَ الدِّينَ وَفَقَدْ هَدَمَ الدِّينَ كُلَّهِ. He has laid waste to his whole deen. Salam, my dear brothers, the final, last wasiyah, the parting advice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was as-salah, as-salah. As-salah, salah, wa ma malakat aymanukum. Don't ever miss your salah. You know, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, when you're stabbed by the Persian blacksmith, Abu Lu'lu', and he was in the state of agony, and his body was all holed up, and he was unconscious most of the time. And it says in narrations that when he would drink milk, the milk would start coming out of the wounds of his body. And he would be unconscious, but when it would be salah time, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions would come to him and he would say, Amirul Mu'mineen, just in his ear, As-Salah, that's all. And he'll jolt into awareness and he would say, Ah, Salah, Salah. La deena li man lam yusalli. That whoever does not pray Salah has no deen. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, exactly the same situation. He was on the last few days of his life and he could not even stand. He could not even stand. They would awaken him for salah. And it comes that he woke up three times and he fell unconscious. He'll perform wudu and he'll fall unconscious. He'll perform wudu again and he'll fall unconscious. And he'd have his right arm over Abbas radiallahu anhu, left arm over Ali radiallahu anhu. And the hadith says, وَقَدَمَاهُ تَخُطَّانُ. And his feet would not stabilize on the ground. They'll just come and drag him on the floor and they'll bring him the stuff and he'll pray his salah. Most important salah, my dear brothers, is Fajr. Fajr, Fajr salah. The Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in always worried about the iman. Is our iman still intact or not? Am I a believer or am I a hypocrite? One tabi'i says that I met 70 Sahaba at the end of their lives, at their deathbeds. And every single one of them feared nifaq, hypocrisy on himself, that I might be a munafiq. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu would constantly worry about his iman. This famous story of Hanzala bin Amr, where he says that he was just playing with his wife and kids, and all of a sudden he feared that his iman has gone low. And he rushed towards the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, Nafaqa Hanzala. While he's running to the Prophet, he's calling out, Nafaqa Hanzala, Hanzala is a munafiq, Hanzala is a munafiq. And he meets Abu Bakr on the way, and Abu Bakr goes, where are you going? And he tells him, Abu Bakr goes, yeah, I also feel like a munafiq. Let's both go to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They feared on themselves, nifaq. And he comes regarding Umar radiallahu anhu, say hadith of Bukhari, that he was such that shaitan would not walk on the path that Umar radiallahu anhu would walk on. And he would ask Huzaifa radiallahu anhu, who had the secret list of the munafiqs the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had entrusted him, he would ask him that, I'm not asking you to divulge the secrets of the Prophet. All I'm asking is just confirm to me whether the name of Umar is in the list of hypocrites or not. My dear brothers, you have come very, very far from the trends, from the sentiments of Sahaba, from the aspirations of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. So how do we know? And it is absolutely haram. After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nobody, not a mufti, not a sheikh, not a wali, not even a sahabi, could point to somebody and say, oh, this is a munafiq. Oh, he's a munafiq, he's a munafiq. Nifaq is a condition of the heart, and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows who is a munafiq or not. However, every single one of us is required to look into our own hearts and call ourselves munafiqs. And there is a thermometer for that. There is a gauge whether to determine whether I'm a munafiq today or I'm a mu'min. That gauge, my dear brothers, is Fajr Salah. It's Fajr Salah. That's exactly where the line is drawn. Where am I at Fajr? Where am I at Fajr? The Sahaba would not dare, not Sahaba, Munafiqeen would not dare miss Salah at the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Once, Sulaiman radiallahu anhu, the son of Shifa' bint Abdullah, she was the marketing, the trading standard manager of the time of Umar radiallahu anhu. She was very well versed in the fiqh of marketing and trading. So she would walk around, she would weigh the dough balls to make sure that they have not made small rotis. She would go check the milk, she could tell whether the milk was mixed with water or not. And she would carry a whip as well. And she was very, mashallah, she was a very strong woman. And Umar radiallahu anhu liked her. Her son missed Salah. And that was a very, very high post to have. Her son missed Fajr Salah. Umar radiallahu anhu after Salah said, "Where is Sulaiman?" And they said to Prophet, "Oh, Amirul Mu'minin, you don't know." He goes, "Come on, let's go." Took a jamaat, gushed Fajr time. Straight to the house of Sulaiman. They knocked on the door and Shifa' came out and she got scared that Amirul Mu'minin is at our doorstep in the morning, first thing. And he said, "Where is Sulaiman?" And she understood. And she said, "Omar, don't rush, let me explain. And he said, "Where was he for Fajr?" And she said, "Oh, Amirul Mu'minin, he was praying Salah all night and towards the break of dawn, he got tired. And he said, "Okay, I'll just quickly pray my Fajr Salah and then knock back off to, I'll go back to sleep." And he said, "Tell him to sleep in the night and come to Fajr Salah in the masjid." Abdullah bin Umar says that when we missed someone at Fajr, and this is true, no, he's not talking about hypocrites, he's talking about the Sahaba. When we missed a Sahabi at Fajr, asa'na bihi dhan, we immediately thought he was a munafiq. Whoever prays their Fajr Salah, my dear brothers, you could walk out of the masjid with your chest held high. Allah is your personal bodyguard for that day.
Allah.
Sayyid Hadith, Kana fi dhimmatillah, he is in the protection of Allah. And whoever challenges the protection of Allah, akabbahu Allahu fin nar, he says Allah will throw him into Jahannam headlong. And you know, as Imams and as students of knowledge, many people come to us with their personal problems. And a lot of the Maulvi subs, the ulama will confirm, jinn. Somebody has given me evil eye. Have you seen your face? Who's going to give you an evil eye? You miss Fajr Salah. You're predisposed to every shaitan out there. Nothing could damage you more than your absence at Fajr. Nothing can harm you more. You don't pray your... Say your hadith, two hadith. One is in Bukhari. When a man goes to sleep in the night, shaitan, these are two, I'm amalgamating between two hadith. One is in Bukhari, one is in Tirmidhi. It says that when the man goes to sleep in the night, shaitan ties three knots on the back of his neck. And he goes to sleep. And as it draws near Fajr time, shaitan comforts him like a mother comforts a child. And shaitan says, alayka bi laylin tawil, alayka bi laylin tawil. A long night left. And his alarm will ring, and there is 10 minutes for Fajr Salah, and masjid is 11 minutes walk. And he says, "Yeah, still a long time left, no problem." And he snoozes it again. And he keeps snoozing. And shaitan is really comforting him, and he's proper digging into him that better soldier. It's so nice and so comfortable. And notice lots of people have sleeping problems, but when it comes to Fajr Salah time, their sleeping problems disappear. Their insomnia disappears miraculously. Then they don't need tablets at that time. Sleep in eight. Dear brothers, shaitan says, "Oh, Abi, you know, don't worry about it, just go to sleep, we'll see." So it comes in another hadith, now moving on to Tirmidhi, that when he wakes up against his tiredness and against his heavy drowsiness, and he says the dua, Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana, one of the knots that shaitan had tied on his back opens. And then when he gets out of bed and he performs wudu, another knot opens. And then when he comes to the masjid, the third knot opens. And he prays Salah. The third knot opens, and the hadith concludes, فَأَصْبَحَ نَشِيطًا طَيِّبًا. He wakes up completely fresh and feeling good about himself. He walks out and he's happy. And then he's kind to his wife. And he's kind to his co-workers, his colleagues, his teachers. And he's in a good mood. And the rest of the day is guaranteed a pleasure by Allah. And on the other hand, where shaitan is, you know, trying his best to get better soldier, as soon as the first ray of the sun hits the earth, as soon as the Fajr time expires, wallah, say hadith of Bukhari. He, shaitan stands up until just a moment ago. This is what adu, you cannot get a clearer enemy. Adu mubin means a clear enemy, an open enemy, where you don't have to look whether he's an enemy or not. He's an open face-to-face enemy. He says that as soon as the sun rises and the Fajr time is gone, a moment earlier he was saying better soja. He stands up, he unzips and he pees in your face. Yabulu fi udhuni. Or move it peshab karke chala jata hai. And he walks away. Fa'asbaha, back to Tirmidhi. Well, he wakes up and khabithan, kaslanan. He's all lazy, he's cranky. And he's in a bad mood, he's temperamental. He snaps on his wife, he snaps on his children. And he goes work and he's got that face on. And you know, he's all day, khabithan nafs. He's feeling anxiety, he's feeling depression. Yeah, it's real. And he's feeling anything and everything. And then he's looking over his shoulder. He's scared of jinns. He's scared of ghosts. He's scared of everything. And he should be. He's predisposed to everything out there. Dearest brothers, Fajr Salah is the power of a mu'min. It's the sign of a mu'min. The day I miss my Fajr Salah is the day I should think whether I'm a mu'min or not. The gauge is saying that the tank is empty. It needs refilling. But you can't ignore these warnings, my dear brothers. It all starts with Fajr Salah. There is so much to be said on Fajr Salah.